Okay, so I'll just read everyone. Most common human challenges in this world: fear and insecurity. So we find we are afraid of this, we're afraid of that, we're afraid of passing exam, we're afraid of cannot read this well, cannot do these presentations, cannot wake up early, all these things. Okay. Second idea is the most common human challenges is what I want it now. Everything that we want it instantly. We don't want to wait for the progress. For example, like that one we talk about later. Okay, so we have this habit of always we want it now, and we are not willing to work on it. Okay, next one, blame and criticism. I think most of us like this. Okay, if you do assignment cannot do it well, I said, yeah, that person. It's because of that person. So my marks is low down. So we try to push blame. Hopelessness. Yeah, maybe some of us are at some point of time we find hopeless. Or yeah. Okay, lack of life balances. Okay. Like your life balances, for example, if you're good in social, or you're good in academics, but you're lack of sleep, something like that. Or you're having good sleep, you're having good social, but you have lack of academic result. So something like that. So lack of life balances. Next one is, what is in it for me? Many people like to ask these questions, especially the level of independence. Okay, that one we'll go about it later. The hunger to be understood, conflict differences, and personal satisfaction. Okay, so these are some of the human challenges. But of course, today we're not talking about. For example, you have a plant of flower. Because the plant of flower have the sunlight, so they'll have photosynthesis and then they'll grow. Because the flower have the water, so they'll grow. Because they have no water, so they will die. Okay, something like that. But of course, we're not talking about flower today, and not fish also. We're talking about us. So two things which is very important when we learn from science is stimulus and response. We are what we being affected by our environment, our choices, and many things. Now look at this. Maybe this one is out recording. How many of you come here for Utah not by your choice? Or how many of you come to Utah because you choose it? How many of you come to Utah because you don't know why you come to Utah? I think that's the reason. So you don't know why it's the reason and then you end up in Utah. So something like that. So maybe some of us here, we come to Utah because we've been influenced by our parents. Or maybe no choice because my parents say, come. So I come. Okay? Or you find that my friend is going there. I also want to go. Or what else? Because it's affordable. So you go. So there's a lot of reasons for us to see here. Now, but we are talking about this thing. Now can you see this two line? Did you see this two line? Did you see there is a blank space in between? You saw that? Now this is what we have as a human. Okay. Now, remember the flower story just now? Okay? Now, the flower, if there's no sunlight, they'll die. Or the plant, if there's no water, they'll die. But human, if there's no food, go and find food. You understand? If you don't have the food, you actually have the choice to make in between. You can respond. You don't have to always depend on this and you move on to here. Remember this one human challenges we talk about, blame and victimism. So we apply to our assignment groups. For example, there are 5 persons doing the assignment group and some of them don't want to do. So you cannot say, because they don't want to do, so my result is like this. Because the lecturer teach badly, so my result is like this. There is a space in between. We can be in the space. The space here is, you can choose your response. Okay, can anyone say choice? Choice? Yeah. Try to pronounce it, 1, 2, 3, choice. So this is the power of the word in your life. Nobody can take it from you. You have the choice, okay? Nobody can take the choice from you. You have the choice to decide your responses, okay? So don't be the flower, okay? So whatever things that happen to you, the environment or a parent or anything people say to you, remember this space. You have this space to choose your response. You guys okay? So this is actually the first motivation and first very important thing about what does it mean by being
my bed. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you another slide. We're going to compare two words, responsibility and responsibility. So we're talking about responsibility. As a human, we are able to respond. Okay? So which is the cheating what we learned just now? The stimulus and the response. Between there is a space for us to choose our response. Always remember this. You have the choice to choose your response, which is the better response. Okay? For example, people laugh at you, or people scold at you. You feel very angry, you want to retain it. But remember, you have the space in between. You can choose to come back. You can choose to reconcile or settle things and not react like an animal. Okay? Or react like a plant. Okay, so this is the best part about being a human. Okay, so this is the first thing. Now, you guys okay so far? Okay. Now, I'm going to show you next one. Now, because we are a proactive person, so we're going to learn this simple diagram. Okay, you can see there is a big circle, which we call this as concern. And then the other side, we call this as no concern. Now, generally in our lives, we have many things we're concerned about. For example, our health, our studies, our relationship, our family, our favorite games, Dota anyone, our favorite movie, Running Man anyone. So any other things that there are many things concern you as a human being. Let's assume that we put everything into this circle. This is whatever that you are caring about. Then of course the other things, some of the things that you have no concern. For example, anything happen in China, anything happen in other places of the world, you have no concern. So it separates between two things. You guys okay so far? The things that you concern, the things that you have no concern. Now, the next thing, you're going to see another circle. Just now the red circle is the circle of concern. Now, I'm going to introduce another idea, which we call it as circle of influence. Now, in our world, and each of us at a personal level, we have many things that we are concerned about. But however, all the things that we concern, we may not have control upon that. For example, we have a lot of ideas to talk about our government. Concern, eh? But do we have the influence? For example, that you can go to parliament or to say, yeah, this one vote down or that one. If you can, yeah. But if not, that means the things that you concern is actually within each area. Now, this circle is very powerful because people say that be the change that you want to be. Okay? Be the change that you want to see. So if you want to see the world change, or if you want to see Malaysia change, or if you want to see Utah change, okay? So you have to work within the circle of influence. Now, circle of influence here refers to the people who you have influence or you have control with. For example, you have influence towards your family member because they are your loved ones. So whatever things that you say to them will influence them. Okay? But the things here is not. Okay? So being a practical person requires us to focus on what we have rather than what we don't have. I repeat that. As a practical person, it asks us to focus on what we have rather than what we don't have. Now, if we focus on what we have, for example, right now we are studying, okay, you guys know, right, nobody is accountable for a result, only yourself, okay, only yourself can decide your GPA when you go out. You cannot say, oh, because my mom caused my GPA to become 2, or because my friend, or because of doctor, or because of movie, or because of other reasons. So you have the things that in the middle, okay, you choose to work on it, okay? Now, if you are proactive, actually not you, if we are proactive, because I'm talking about myself as well, if we are proactive, we're going to see two things happening. Now, as a proactive person, you find that your circle of
influence will expand. Okay? This will happen because we are trying to focus on what we have. For example, we are studying, so we try to study well. Okay? If you have a family member, try to love them, okay? Because these are the people that is given to you. And then you will have greater capacity in future to do the things that you want. For example, you really want to change the government. For example, anyone here don't want to change government? Anyone have their own government? 我是政府, I am the law, okay? So you have your own ways of thinking how a government should operate. If yes, why not? Work for yourself from here, okay? Be a person, okay? Be a person who is able to work all your way to serve the government, okay? I think all of us know this. If you really want to help the government or help anyone, you have to be there. You have to be available. You have to be equipped. So now is the best time for you to equip. Then you can solve the problem which you're concerned about. Okay, now let's change another perspective. If we are not proactive, that means we are reactive. We like to say, the person always like that. The organization always like that. Then we're actually moving to here. We spend most of our time criticizing, comparing, shrinking, or put down anyone which is not being good to us. We're actually empower them. And you find that actually your circle of influence is getting lesser and lesser. In the end, people will say we are hypocrite. You can say that, yeah, but you didn't do. I think you heard this before a lot of times. You have many good speech. Yeah, you have very good, good things to say, but no help, you know. Okay? You guys okay so far? So these are the two things that we are focusing when it comes to being a proactive person. Okay? Focus on what you have. So I believe all of us have our family members, maybe your loved one as well, your study. I think these are three basic things right now. Focus on what you have. Okay? Don't focus on what you don't have. Money, career, work in Singapore, or any other things, that will wait. Focus on what you have right now, being a proactive person. Okay?